Now, listen, you guys, it seems like there is a songwriter out there blasting several artists, including Beyonce and Tamar Braxton, as well as Zendaya. We're also going to be talking about Christian Rock. She is back, you guys. The noise has started. And we're also going to be talking about Benzino crying and Coily Rae's delusion when it comes to the Grammys. Now, these are some of the things that we're going to be talking about in this video. Hello, tea lovers, and welcome to the tea plug. I trust you guys are doing well, and I trust you are doing great. Personally, I am doing great, you guys. I am doing extremely amazing. And without further ado, let us dive straight into today's theme. So first of all, you guys, we are going to be talking about Benzino. Benzino was out there crying, okay, about this entire Eminem situation. And one thing about Benzino is wherever he goes, he makes sure to put out a show, okay? He may not say anything, but trust me, his neck will do the talking for him. This time, him and his neck were out here crying, basically saying that, oh my goodness, I love Eminem. I don't know that man. And he made a whole like spectacle of the entire interview, and he was crying.
Nothing against Eminem. Got nothing against Eminem. Eminem can rap, but I care about us more. I don't want to go through, I don't want to talk about it no more. I don't want. For 22 years, every time I do an interview, they ask me about Eminem. The fuck you want me to do? Come on, man. My daughter came into the industry figuring that, hey, I gotta be cool with Eminem because everybody's against my dad.
He was explaining how, you know, his daughter Coily Rae has had to kiss the behind of the man in quotes, and the man in question is obviously Eminem, has had to kiss Eminem's behind, just so, you know, she won't face the heat that the father was getting. And honestly speaking, the internet really had a lot of things to say about this entire situation. Personally, I do understand why this might make him feel emotional, but the whole crying and all the theatrics, I feel like those ones were also a result of alcohol, because I think he was actually drinking during that interview. And yeah, so do let me know, you guys, in the comment section, did you see this entire interview of Benzino out there crying? Okay, I'm just gonna try and set a snippet of him, you know, with all the drama and theatrics. And it's very funny to me when he's out there talking about how Coily Rae has had to kiss behind, and I'm like, oh, so she actually does pick and choose who to have beef with, okay? So when it comes to certain female rappers who've actually assisted her in her career, she feels very comfortable going for them. But when it's actually, you know, other guys who haven't really helped her career, she's out there, you know, dodging, beefing with them. Still speaking about Coily Rae, you guys, it seems like she is still living in Delulu land, and please take me to where that land is, because it must be blissful, okay? She was out there talking about how she put female rap on the map. Now, this is how I know that somebody is irredeemably delusional, okay? She said that after all of my hard work, dedication, and putting female rap on the map, this is what I get in return. Bullish. And I'm like, girl, putting female rap on the map, was it not on the map before? Like, am I missing something? Like, which song of hers put female rap on the map? I'm trying to understand, you guys. Like, help me out here. I was just like, there's nothing wrong with being confident, but this level of confidence is, there's a thin line between being confident and being delusional, and I think she has crossed that line, in my own opinion, okay? The audacity of her saying that she has put female rap on the map, and I'm just like, girl, go away. Bye-bye, Coily Rae, okay? So let me know, you guys, in the comment section, what you think about Coily Rae and her delusion, okay? The next thing that we're gonna be talking about, you guys, Beyonce is under fire. Well, there is a songwriter who was out there putting people on blast, okay? And she was basically complaining that a lot of times artists take credit for work that they would have done, and they get led to minimal you know, support when it comes to you know, publishing rights and stuff like that. And it seems like she went in on a lot of celebrities. Some of the celebrities that she called out, she called out even Seven, she called out you know, Zendaya, she called out Tamar Braxton and Beyonce as well. And she said that she had a hadn't worked with Beyonce herself, but she knows someone who would work with her, was like, they're trying to dodge, Beyonce's smoke, so they won't speak up even if they feel like they're being treated unfairly. So I'm just going to quickly insert that video and then we'll catch you on the other side and you guys will discuss on how exactly this is like.
I earn on the songs that I wrote for them is because there is a precedent that's set. The reason why I called out Beyonce is because Beyonce is the Michael Jackson of our generation. And so if there's anybody that could reshape the precedent, if there's anybody that could influence the industry, that had the power and the money and the cultural like thing to say, you know what, y'all, you're right. These songwriters have been out here. We've been in the street, literally. And what I will not allow is for anybody to make me feel like I'm in the Twilight Zone, because I know I'm not in the Twilight Zone. I can pull up my records. I talked to somebody yesterday. Somebody's a manager of somebody who is a writer and producer on Renaissance, okay? The record is one of y'all faves. The song was written 6 years before it got to Beyonce. She got 25% of the song. I've talked to another writer who wrote and sang on one of your favorite songs. Credit not right, all kind of shit fucked up. His business still isn't handled. Beyonce was on tour last year with that record, with that person's vocals, all that. I'm not crazy. And here's the thing. The reason why people who work for Beyonce don't talk is because they're all on NDAs. Because that's also how she works. She silences people so that nobody can speak. I'm not a writer that's written for Beyonce. I haven't shot my shot at Beyonce because I'm not willing to give her any publishing. Not because I haven't had the opportunity. I've had the opportunity to work with everybody. And I've turned down a lot of stuff because I'm not willing to play these games. There's a massive power dynamic happening. Please don't act like it's easy to negotiate with Beyonce and her team, because it is not. If that was the case, there would not be so many people coming to me like, Tiff, this is how much was taken. Shit is not negotiable. It's not. These are the terms, which means, okay, cool. Then we work for you, Beyonce. So that means you're an employer. But either way, to imply that the artists do not have to be responsible for the business practices that they exercise with songwriters, to insinuate that the only way you are treated fairly is if you are meant to be in company with a gatekeeper to be treated fairly. You should not have to have a gatekeeper on your team to make a livable wage off of music that is making people billionaires. Them Grammys don't pay the bills. Those plaques do not pay the bills. There are people with Grammys and plaques who can't pay their rent. I know people who are super accredited, broke.
Well, there you had it, people. So obviously this was received with mixed feelings by people saying that, oh, well, she had no right speaking on Beyonce since she herself hasn't directly worked with Beyonce. And in that entire situation, people also started asking her, like, where do you fit? If you're saying you haven't worked with Beyonce, so what right do you have to speak on it? Ungena happy and stuff like that. And so let me know, you guys, in the comment section what you think about this entire situation. She also did slide in Taylor Swift in this entire situation, saying that Taylor Swift writes her own songs, and obviously people felt like that was an indirect jab and stuff like that. So let me know, you guys, what you think about all of that in the comment section. All right, now the next thing that I'm gonna be talking about, lottery ticket has got YT men, white-headed YT men out there erasing those Ice Spice tracks that basically have the printing that you think you're the ish. So those men are out there, you know, canceling out that print and putting Ghoststream Sunday Service. And now rumor on the street has it that, well, that man who actually took a picture in front of that truck is none other than Lottery Tickets Angle. Now, I do not know how far true that is. I don't know how far true that is, but I found it hilarious that we would be having... So these are the seven fans that Lottery Ticket has. I cannot believe it. And you guys wonder why she's not out there selling. If this is the caliber of her fans, I'm sorry, you guys. But if this is the caliber of her fans, you guys, I no wonder why she's out there always flopping. Do you think they even know what Spotify is? I'm just kidding, you guys. Of course, they do know what that is. But I'm just saying, how many times is he going to listen to a Lato song and even understand what she's saying? Oh, my goodness. What a person to be a face of, you know, her fans. Like, literally, now when you mention Lottery Ticket fans, that's the picture that I have in mind. So let me know in the comment section what you think about this entire situation, you guys. The next thing that we're going to be talking about, you guys, Chris Brown. It seems like Chris Brown has added with people blackballing her. He feels like people are not being fair at all and feels like, well, people as choose and select, you know, who exactly to cancel, okay? This is what Chris Brown had to say on his story, and he's accusing the NBA of, you know, basically canceling him. He said, I was asked by the NBA to play in the All-Star game this year, only for them to call me later and say they couldn't do it because of their sponsors like Ruffles. At this point, I'm sick of people bothering me and I'm tired of living in the effing past. I posted the email so y'all could see. The NBA still was trying to get me to come and sit courtside, not effing happening. And he sent through, he posted the email that he got from the NBA, and I'm just gonna insert it in here. And he said, I only go where I am appreciated. I did see today he added on to say that, oh well, you guys are out there, you know, canceling me, but you know, at the same time, you're out there binge watching Blueface being toxic and stuff, you know, and putting his hands on women, and at the same time, you are out here, you know, canceling me. Like, I've always said this about the music industry. It's not fair at all. I know that there are a lot of people in the industry that get away with doing way worse than, you know, the people that actually do get cancelled, okay? Lately, we have seen the Brother Love situation coming out. Now, we're going to see 5 years from now, are they still going to keep the same energy, or they're just going to sweep it under the rug, wait for people, for the, you know, buzz to die down, and then come back as in this business as usual? I'm really waiting to see how that situation is going to play out. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I do understand his frustrations, you know, and where he's coming from. So let me know, you guys, in the comment section what you think about that. He also said, Ruffles sponsored last night's NBA All-Star Celebrity Game. However, we did not have any involvement in nor visibility to any player decisions or celebrity invite discussion. He reposted this, okay? And it seems like people are not buying it. People are like, okay, Ruffles is now only speaking up because, you know, people of color were out there saying that, well, they're not going to be spending their dimes on them, and they noticed that it's now hurting their pocket, and that's when they decided to speak. So it seems like people were still not messing with them on that regard. So let me know your sentiments about this entire situation with Chris Brown, okay, you guys? Do you think that they're doing, you know, the most still canceling him? Personally, I do feel like I understand his frustrations about it not being fair that one person gets to be canceled and another person doesn't face any consequences. But at the same time, if you have done something, at some point you have to pay, you have to face the consequences. Do you understand what I'm saying? Regardless of whether others are getting the consequences, you can't then cry out to say, we can't be supporting, you know, the idea that just because some people are getting away with doing what's wrong, we need to make sure that everybody gets away with doing what's wrong. I don't know if I'm making any sense. Maybe I'm not. So let me know, you guys, in the comment section here, what you think about that, okay? And the last thing that I'm going to be talking about, you guys, the trouble is big. Christian Rock is big on the algorithm, you guys. And honestly speaking, we had had so much peace these past weeks. We had so much peace because the Smith family was nowhere to be seen on the internet. But it seems like the theatrics have yet started, okay? This is what Christian Rock had to say. She said, this big bag, what think you finna get a cent out of me? B, you know you just wasted your money on the damn lawyer, right? And I'm like, for somebody who actually assaulted someone, that's some nerve, that's some basketballs. Like, do you understand what I'm saying? So with Christian right now, honestly speaking, I'm just tired of this girl. Like, I'm over her. So I don't know, you guys, let me know what you think about her coming for James Wright like that, okay? James Wright is obviously Tamar Braxton's friend who pressed charges for what happened between him and Christian Rock. So yeah, for those of you who don't know what this is about, so yeah, thank you very much, you guys, for watching, and thank you very much for making it this far. If you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button and do turn on the notification bell so that you'll be notified each and every time that I post each and every single day, and I keep you updated on what is happening in the celebrity world on Instagram, on Twitter, and about all things trending. We are on the road to 15,000 subscribers, so you know what to do. Until my next one, see you.